Saturday Night Live has taken a rare break from mocking President Donald Trump, with one segment even admitting it's been a good week for the administration. Unusually, both guest host Amy Schumer's monologue and the episode's cold open avoided politics, a rarity in the Trump era, in which Alec Baldwin typically appears to impersonate the president. The Weekend Update segment devoted only 3 minutes to politics, and the episode's only other jab at Trump was a throwaway line during a parody of The Handmaid's Tale. The episode opened with several of the cast members' mothers joining them on the set in honor of Mother's Day. Several of the moms made fun of SNL for its habit of piling on Trump. Kenan Thompson's mom told him that she likes the show, except for all of the political stuff, adding, "We get it." When Mikey Day reminded his mother that he was in a production of The Crucible in high school, she replied that the play about the Salem witch trials was a lot like the witch hunt against President Trump. "Enough with the Trump jokes," said Luke Nell's mother. "And why doesn't SNL ever talk about crooked Hillary?" Chris Redd's mother was fed up with the political jokes as well. "I don't understand why everyone's focused on Trump at all, when you should be focused on Jesus," she said. "Jesus isn't president, Mom," the comic responded to his mom. "And that's the problem," she said. Even the Weekend Update segment, which usually uses the Trump administration as a punching bag, devoted only 3 minutes to politics. "You know, I've gotta admit President Trump had a pretty good week," said co-host Colin Jost. "He secured the release of 3 American prisoners from North Korea, and when he greeted them at the airport he didn't even say, 'Wait, I thought they were Americans.' The 3 freed hostages were all ethnically Korean and believed to be naturalized U.S. citizens born in South Korea. Trump bragged that him greeting the freed hostages was probably the highest ever TV ratings for 3 o'clock in the morning, which is not true," Jost continued. The 3 a.m. ratings record was set on election night by liberals hoping they were being pranked. "Sure, this has been a decent week for Donald Trump," observed co-host Michael Chi. "The same way a decent date with R. Kelly is to go home dry." The hosts also made a few quick jokes about former Trump attorney Michael Cohen, Robert Mueller's probe, and Trump's exit from the Iran deal. "You know, the only part of that deal Trump has read was the signature on the bottom, that said Barack Obama," said Chi. "Trump is undoing so much of Obama's work that he's going to start fading away in old pictures like Back to the Future." After moving on to non-political news, the Weekend Update segment ended with Chi attempting to read a joke about Rudy Giuliani, only to be interrupted by his stepmother, played by Melissa McCarthy. The lengthy gag saw McCarthy pull up a seat and distract Chi for several minutes, leaving him unable to deliver the punchline. The episode's only other mention of Trump came in an easily missed line during a parody of The Handmaid's Tale, played as a spoof on Sex in the City. "Who would have thought we'd be having 3 ways in our 30s," said Adie Bryant, in reference to The Handmaid's role bearing children for politically powerful married couples in the fictional dystopia. "3-way? How about a 1-way ticket out of here?" Schumer's character replied. At the end of the sketch, one handmaid mentions that she is Trumpetized. SNL's sudden retreat from political humor comes as broadcaster NBC Universal prepares to host powerful advertisers at a party on Sunday and presentation on Monday for Upfronts Week.